So do your eyes burn or feel irritated? Well, maybe you have blepharitis. And in this video, I'm gonna be explaining exactly what blepharitis is and how you can treat it at home. So let's take a look. This video is brought to you by Ocusoft, the number one doctor-recommended brand of eyelid cleansers. Hey everyone, this is Dr. Joe Allen here from Dr. Eye Health, the channel that helps with the eyes, vision, and finding the best vision products. And on this channel, you'll find us doing a lot of different product reviews, as well as educational videos just like this one. So if you're new here, consider subscribing so you don't miss any of my future videos. Also remember that at any point throughout the video, you could check out the show notes and links below for further information about everything that I go over. Otherwise, let's talk about blepharitis. So blepharitis is a general term describing the inflammation of the eyelids themselves. Now, most commonly we describe this as marginal blepharitis because the inflammation is right on the eyelid margin, the part right by where the eyelids are opening. And this is extremely common. In fact, most people either have blepharitis right now, this exact second, or they've already had it when they were younger, or they're gonna get it again when they're older. It's actually that common. The symptoms of blepharitis are usually inflamed, irritated eyelids, they're chronically red, itchy, and kind of have a burning sensation. Now, there's actually different types or classifications of blepharitis. In the clinic, we either call it anterior blepharitis or posterior blepharitis based on where it's located and what's causing it. Now, anterior blepharitis is where you actually have inflammation of the eyelashes and hair follicles. And this usually kind of looks like kind of like a dandruff or an oil buildup on the surface of the eyelid. And kind of imagine it kind of like scalp dandruff, but on the eyelashes themselves. Now, sometimes it's tough to see this unless you have high-powered magnification like we have in the eye clinic, but again, it's very, very common. But it's not just dead skin cells and oil that are building up on the lashes. Actually, bacteria live in these oils, and those bacteria actually produce toxins that interact with the oils, and that causes instability of your tear film and eventual dry eye disease. Now again, there's anterior blepharitis, and then there's posterior blepharitis. And posterior blepharitis involves inflammation of the backside of the eyelid, which involves the meibomian glands. Now if you've never heard of the meibomian glands before, they're actually these rows of little glands that run on the bottom portion of your eyelid and on the top portion of the eyelid. And they function that every time you blink, they squeeze these glands just a little bit, and a little bit of this oil comes out and floats on your tear film and prevents the tears from evaporating. And if these oil glands aren't functioning properly, either that they're not producing enough or the quality is very low, then your tears start to evaporate almost instantly. And so it's actually the number one leading cause for all of dry eye disease. In fact, if you are somebody who has either really bad dry eye and you want to learn more about dry eye treatment, I have a whole other playlist on that, and I'll hook that up here in the YouTube card above as well as in the description below if you want to check that out. Now again, this inflammation and dysfunction of these meibomian glands are part of posterior blepharitis, but they're almost always present with anterior blepharitis to some degree. But this dysfunction of the meibomian glands, it actually has many different causes, including aging, hormones, genetics, and even contact lens wear. Okay, so how do you treat blepharitis at home? Well, what's great is that blepharitis is easily treatable, and a lot of times it's preventable, just with good eyelid hygiene. And so I have this discussion with a lot of my patients who are like teenagers getting contact lenses for the first time, and I'll look at their eyelids and they don't look that clean. So I'll discuss with them the importance of cleaning away all this extra debris on the eyelid. And this is a matter of washing your face basically every day. I don't like getting soap in my eyes or anything either, and I think most of us kind of neglect really cleaning away on the eyelids. But you want to find a soap that's not really irritating to the eyes, and there are some really excellent ones out there, and we're going to go over some of those. Now, you may have seen either lid wipes or foaming eyelid cleansers like these either at your doctor's office or at the store. And both work excellent for treating blepharitis because they have surfactants that actually help remove oil and debris away from the eyelid and has some effect against some types of bacteria. With these type of eyelid pads, you know, you can buy these at the store or online, and I'll hook you up with some links in the description below. But really, you just open it up, you take out the pre-moistened pad, then you unfold it, and you can see it's a little bit soapy, but then you basically just close your eyes, and then you clean the eyelids. So you can just close the eyes here. You can rub along the eyelid margin. You clean of all of the eyelashes, including the brow as well. And then you go ahead and you just clean right along that eyelid margin. Really get at those lashes, okay? Of course, you do it on the one side, then you do it on the other. Same thing. Then rinse. Once you're done drying off your eyelids, then it's really just a matter of repeating this at least twice a day for about 2 weeks in really bad cases. Otherwise, you want to just regularly maintain good eyelid hygiene. Now, again, these are convenient kind of pre-moistened pads. They're excellent because you can put them in your purse or your wallet, or you can take it with you somewhere. But I otherwise like to use the foaming eyelid cleansers because it's just a little bit more gentle on my skin. Now, beyond just using the lid scrubs in those really severe outbreaks and cases, doctors are now recommending maintenance eyelid hygiene with hypochlorous acid. And if you've never heard of hypochlorous acid before, this is the Ocusoft Hypochlor brand. It's a very safe, non-toxic spray that goes on the eyelids, and it fights many, many different bacteria. And so that's why many doctors are recommending it now. I do have a whole other video on hypochlorous acid if you want to know more about that, and I'll hook that up here in the YouTube card above, as well as in the description below if you want to check that out. But what I like is that Ocusoft is actually packaging a clean and spray kit now, so it actually includes 20 of the lid scrubs and a full bottle of the hypochlorous acid. So you don't have to actually buy like a full set of the lid scrubs by themselves and then the hypochlorous acid by themselves. You can do that if you want, but it does come in a full kit now, and I'll hook that up for you in a link in the description below. Now, I personally don't just clean my eyelids every day with something like hypochlorous acid. That helps, again, fight the bacteria and the oils from building up on the surface of the eyelids. But I have issues with the oil glands on the back surface of my oil glands. So I do have some posterior blepharitis issues. And really what I do to help with that is something called a warm compress. And I love doing these things. It's actually something I look forward to. But a warm compress, there's different ways to do that. But I personally prefer the ones that are like microwavable heat packs, ones that you can put in the microwave. I just find them more convenient. They get to a hotter degree and last longer. Again, using those heat packs every day is going to help melt those oils, the thickened oils stuck in the meibomian glands, so that they actually run smoother and it allows them to kind of run more freely. So that way it doesn't get clogged up and then those meibomian glands continue to live on. And I find the combination of those two, doing both the eyelid cleansing and the heat compresses, kind of works synergistically together, because then you're treating both the anterior blepharitis and the posterior blepharitis together. So I have a question of the day. Have you ever tried any of these products? Do you like the lid scrubs better, or do you like the hypochlorous acid spray better? Go ahead and comment in the section below. I'd love to hear what you think. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching. If you liked the video, give me a big thumbs up. Subscribe if you're new. And if you'd like to catch other cool videos in my whole series about eyelid hygiene and eyelid health, go ahead and click or tap the screen just over here to the side. Or if you'd like to catch another cool video from Dr. Eye Health, just click or tap the screen down over here. Otherwise, again, this is Dr. Allen here from Dr. Eye Health, the channel that helps with the eyes, vision, and finding the best vision products. Keep an eye on it. We'll talk to you soon.